Hello sir, my name is Lolita and this is something related to Bible. So in Bible it is written we should not worship idols. Then why in Roman Catholic Church we have Jesus and all saints, Mary's idols and is it right worshiping them? Because as per Bible we shouldn't worship it. So what we are doing, is it right according to Bible?
Sister has asked a very good question. What she is referring to is the verse of the Bible in the book of Deuteronomy, chapter number 5, verse number 7, and the book of Exodus, chapter number 20, verse number 3 to 5, it says, thou shalt have no other image beside, thou shalt have no other God besides me. Thou shalt not make unto thee any image of any graven image of anything, of any likeness in the heaven above, in the earth beneath, in the water beneath the earth. Thou shalt not bow down to them, nor serve them, for I, thy God, thy Lord, is a jealous God. So according to the Bible, Old Testament as well as the New Testament, you should not make any image of Almighty God. You should not make any images. So your question is right, sister, that then why do the Roman Catholics make images? That's what you are perfectly right, sister. Making images of Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, or of Mother Mary, or of any other saint, is totally prohibited according to the Bible. That is the reason the Protestants, they don't make any idol of Jesus Christ, peace be upon him. So making images is wrong, sister. So you should put this question to the Catholics.
No, I have already, checked with the priest, but I did not get a convincing answer.
Sister, what they are doing is wrong, sister.
They are saying that just to have a concentration, we have those idols. So what is the difference between concentration and faith then?
That's right. That's perfect. That's the reason, that's what the Hindus also say. They say that if you reach higher consciousness, then idol is not required for concentration. If that's the question, if that's the reason, then we Muslims have already reached that higher consciousness. So sister, do you believe in one God?
Yes, I do believe.
Do you believe Jesus is God?
Jesus is not God. It's not written anywhere. He is just the Son of God.
Son of
God,
messenger of God?
No one knows who is God. He is yet to come. That's what I believe.
No, you believe that Jesus is messenger of God?
Yes, right.
Okay. So you believe God is yet to come. God doesn't come. God is already present, sister. Yet to come means, do you mean that God is not there?
No, because there's a judgment day and...
Correct. So on the judgment day, we will meet God.
That's what.
We'll meet God. But now, in this life, we'll not meet God. Once we die and when we're resurrected, on judgment we'll meet Him.
I heard that judgment day is near. It is not like after death there will be a judgment day. So, it is something like, we never know when is the judgment day. It is very near.
No, sister. The judgment day will only come, even according to the Quran, according to the Bible, only after you die and after you're resurrected. If the judgment day takes now, what about those people who have died? How will they attend the judgment day, sister?
I'm
asking, suppose judgment day comes today. What about the people who have died 1,000 years back?
Therefore, they already have their judgment day.
No, that is wrong, sister. The teaching of Islam is that once you die, you are dormant, you are in barzakh. It's okay. Interim life. On the day of judgment, all the human beings from Adam al-Salam till the last day will be resurrected. They'll be again given life. And once the life is given, then the judgment will take place. And based on your good deeds and bad deeds, then depending upon you go to heaven or hell, sister. Hope you understand.
Yes. So what you're saying is this idol worship, what we are doing in Roman Catholic Church is completely wrong, right?
Completely wrong according to the Bible, according to the Quran also.
But is there any way that we can give them a convincing answer, like priest or anyone?
No, the answer that I have given, I have quoted to you from the Bible, sister.
Yeah, right. But how can I convince them?
So you tell them if they don't believe, so they are at fault, they will suffer, not you.
Okay.
Our job is to tell, I'm telling the Christians. Many Christians come to the straight path. Many Christians who worship Jesus Christ as God, then they stop worshipping and they come on the straight path. Many Christians even accept Islam. Alhamdulillah. So our job is to tell, we cannot force anyone, sister. So if they get convinced, good. If they don't get convinced, you pray for them, sister.
All right. Thank you, sir.
Sister, I am asking you, do you believe
Prophet Muhammad? Yeah.
Do you believe that he is the messenger of God?
Yes, I do believe.
Do you believe there is one God?
I do believe that.
And you believe Jesus is also a messenger of God?
All right.
Then you are a Muslim, sister. So what you are saying, sister...
Even I do the fasting for 27th day, so
mashallah,
I do follow
mashallah,
that.
Mashallah. So sister, according to me, you are a Muslim then?
Yes.
So would you like to say the Shahada? In Arabic, would you like to say that? What I asked you in English.
I
asked you in English, do you believe in one God? You said yes.
I do believe, but...
So if you believe in one God, you said
but
yes.
But I need to learn some more, that's why I need
No,
to...
learning is secondary, sister.
No,
first
need...
you have to... First you have to take admission in the school, then you have to learn. You cannot say, I will first learn and then take admission in school. First you take admission, you fulfill the criteria of admission. Once you fulfill the criteria of admission, you join the school and you learn. You cannot say that first I will learn and become a graduate and then join school, sister.
No, because my roommate, she's a Muslim and she has told me she'll gift me a Quran, so
that's
I
That's fine, don't wait. It's not necessary you have to get the Quran and then become a Muslim. According to me, you're already a Muslim. If you say the Shahada, you will become practicing slowly, slowly. Once you say the Shahada, what I've already said in English. Once you say in Arabic, it will give you more power, inshallah, to practice Islam. So would you like to say in Arabic, sister?
Not now.
So when you say it? No, according to me, I already said it. According to me, when
yeah,
I asked you in English.
As you already disclosed.
In English, you have said it.
Yeah, as you
Even
already
if you
said.
Say in English, you become a Muslim. You don't have to say it in Arabic, sister.
Yeah, as you already said, it is not required to say in front of anyone. So,
yes.
And it's me and between the God. That
yes, I'm understood, sister. Jazakallah, may Allah give you more hidayah. And may Allah give you opportunity to give hidayah to your other non-Muslim friends, sister.
Thank you, sir.
Jazakallah, sister.